Skin friction drag occurs when airflow surrounding an object is disturbed by imperfections in the surface or skin around which the air is flowing. For example, competitive swimmers wear swim caps, fitted swimsuits, and shave their hair to have smoother skin. These tactics reduce overall swimming time because they're cutting down the amount of resistance in the water. If a swimmer did not cover their head with a cap, or if they wore a loose suit, the athlete would have to work harder in order to overcome the resistance. With less resistance on their bodies, swimmers are better able to overcome a lot of the skin friction drag. Similarly, an aircraft also meets resistance when its surfaces are not smooth. When viewed at a molecular level, every surface, regardless of how smooth it appears, has some level of roughness. This aircraft is no different. Look at all those surface irregularities. Skin friction drag is the aerodynamic resistance due to the contact of moving air on the surface of the aircraft. To understand skin drag further, let me show you a few things about the space called the boundary layer. For this example, we'll look at an arbitrary section such as the upper portion of the right wing. The boundary layer is really thin. At most, it's about the thickness of a playing card in level flight. For our purposes, we'll break it down into three sections. These are the laminar boundary layer, the transition region, and the turbulent boundary layer. Let's go through an example to see the path of air molecules through the boundary layer. In flight, the air molecules that come in direct contact with the surface become virtually motionless for a brief moment due to surface roughness. After the stagnation point, the air molecules continue along its path. As the flight progresses and molecules move rearward past the leading edge and laminar boundary layer, the molecules enter the transition region. The transition region is identified by an increase in height and has more turbulent swirls as compared to the laminar boundary layer. Molecules farthest away from the wing surface tend to move at faster velocities and are least affected by the turbulence of the boundary layer. These air molecules are in a free flow zone and contribute a minimum amount of drag. Now, at some distance behind the leading edge, the smooth laminar boundary layer breaks down and transitions to a turbulent flow. In the turbulent boundary layer, I want you to remember that airflow separation is at its greatest, producing the highest amount of drag, which ultimately destroys your lift. Just like the swimmer, you can reduce skin friction drag by making sure your aircraft is smooth and clean, ensuring it's free from dirt, bugs, ice, and debris.